How could we attempt to solve the load balancing problem? One idea would be to try some kind of greedy algorithm. So consider all of the n jobs in some arbitrary order. And then we start with empty machines and no jobs assigned to any machines. Take the first job in your order and place it on the machine that currently has the smallest amount of load. If there's a tie and two machines have the equally low load, then place it on either one of them. Once you've done that, you take the next job and place that on the machine that now has the lowest load, and so on. So we can look at our example again. Initially, none of the machines have any load, so the first job can really go anywhere. Let's just put it on machine number one. The second job, well, when we try to allocate the second job, the second and the third machine have zero load, so we can put it on either one of those machines, but let's say we put it on machine number two, and then the third job really has to go to machine number three, because that now uniquely is the machine that has the lowest load. After we place the first three jobs, this just continues, the fourth job has to go to machine two, and so on. We keep placing the jobs always on the machine that at that time has the smallest load among all the machines. And eventually we will have assigned all 10 jobs to machines in some way. We get a solution this way, but how good is that solution? Is the solution optimal? Do we get the lowest possible make span? Maybe not. I mean, we don't really know anything about it so far. In our example, machine number two has the highest load, so that determines the make span of our solution. But is it possible to get a solution with a lower make span? And in this particular example, in fact, there is a solution that has a smaller make span. So the solution is like this. By the way, we can see that this is indeed the optimal solution. That is because the load on all three machines is equal. If it were possible to reduce the make span even further, it would mean that we have to reduce the load on some machine. But that would, of course, increase the load on some other machine, because the jobs have to go somewhere. And because we look at the maximum load on any machine, that means if we did this, the make span would only increase rather than decrease. So this is really best possible. It's not always as easy to see whether a solution is best possible or not, because it is not always possible to get a perfectly balanced load. So in general, it's quite difficult to determine whether a particular solution is optimal or not. But in this particular example, I made it easy, and it's obvious once you see the solution. As we can see, the solution of our greedy algorithm isn't necessarily optimal. But the question is whether we can prove any type of approximation guarantees for this particular algorithm. And indeed, it's possible to do this, and I will explain how in the following. This is a very old result from 1966 from Graham, which states that this particular algorithm gives a true approximation for the load balancing problem. And it was the first time that an approximation algorithm was formally analyzed and worst case guarantees were given for the approximation factor of the algorithm. When we analyze an approximation algorithm, we have to compare the solution produced by the approximation algorithm to an optimal solution, in this case, the optimal make span. Let's call the optimal make span for a particular input instance L star. Then what can we say about the value of L star? Ideally, we want to know that L star cannot be arbitrarily small. We need some type of lower bound for the value of the optimal make span in order to be able to guarantee that the make span we produce is not that much bigger than the optimal make span. Fortunately, in the case of load balancing, there are two fairly obvious lower bounds for the optimal make span. The first one is simply that we know that the optimal make span needs to be at least as large as the maximum processing time of any job. And this is just because this job that has the maximum processing time needs to be allocated to some machine, and that machine will run for at least that amount of time. The load of that machine will be at least the load of the processing time of that job. And therefore, even the optimum make span has to be at least as large as the maximum processing time of any job. So that's the first easy lower bound for the optimum make span. The second easy lower bound for the optimum make span is that the optimum make span needs to be at least as large as the average load on the machines under any assignment. So if you just sum up all the processing times of all the jobs and divide it by the number of machines, then that is a lower bound for the optimal make span. And this is because the total work to be done in the system by all machines together is just the sum of all the processing times of all the jobs. And so there must be one machine out of the m machines that processes at least a 1 over m fraction of that total work. Now we just need to use those two lower bounds on the optimal make span and somehow get an upper bound on the make span that our greedy algorithm produces and compare the two in some way. Consider the situation after our greedy algorithm has assigned all of the jobs. Then there is a machine with maximum load. Consider such a machine. Say it's machine I. And consider the load on that machine, which consists of one or more jobs. Ask yourself, what was the last job that was assigned to machine I by our greedy algorithm? Let's say this is job J. And think about the time at which job J was assigned to that machine. What were the loads of all the machines like at that point in time? Because we use a greedy algorithm, it must be the case that all the machines had a load that was at least equal or more than the load on machine I at that time. We know that the optimal make span has to be at least as large as this common load on all the machines. And then on top of that, the load of machine I increases by another Tj, where Tj is the processing time of job J. But again, we know that the optimum make span must be at least as large as Tj, because we know that the optimum make span is as large as the processing time of any single job. And therefore, we know that in total, the load in machine I is at most twice the optimal make span. We can make this a bit more formal using symbols and so on. So let's actually write this down in a more formal calculation. The final load of machine I is Li. And when job J was assigned to that machine, if job J is the last job assigned to that machine, then the load before job J was assigned must be Li minus Tj. And as we have observed, Li minus Tj really needs to be smaller, or at least not larger, than the load on any other machine. So all the other loads, Lk for any other k, needs to be at least as large as Li minus Tj. And now it is just a question of summing this inequality up over all values of k, and then dividing both sides by m. Now, we can see that The sum over all the final loads of the machines divided by m is really just the total work in the system divided by m. And so that must be equal to the total processing times of all the jobs divided by m. And we know that that, in turn, is at most the optimum make span. We can now put everything together. So the final load of machine I is Li, which is equal to Li minus Tj plus Tj. So we just split it into the load we had before we assigned the last job j and the load that is contributed by job j itself. And we know that both of those components are individually bounded by the optimum make span L star. And so in total, this is just bounded by 2 times L star, proving that this greedy algorithm is a true approximation because the make span it produces is at most twice as large as the optimum one.